Hello, 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 everybody. I hope everyone is having an amazing day. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for tuning in with me, whether you're tuning in live at this moment or whether you're going to watch the recording. So to all my Facebook fans, to all of my fans on Periscope, thank you, thank you, thank you. I am Prophetess Trish Morissette. I want to just take the time to thank you for coming on. Hey, thank you, Jeff. I'm so happy you're able to get on today. Please make sure you guys invite your followers to tune in. I missed you guys on last week. Schedule was crazy. I was short-staffed in the office due to sickness. This flu thing, y'all, is trying to get everybody and knock people down and all of that. But it is well. I am back here on today to inspire, to encourage, and to release a word that will help catapult you to your destiny. And so thank you guys for hanging with me on today. I'm Prophetess Trish Morissette. I am the visionary of Trish M Ministries. I am also the executive pastor serving alongside my wonderful husband, senior pastor, Derek Morissette of Mind of Christ International, right here in Alabaster, Alabama. And hey guys, we have a women's conference coming up this next weekend, next Friday at 7 p.m. And we want you to be there. Yes, it's called our I Am Fabulous Women's Empowerment Conference. And we're doing a flash sale for registration of only $25 today. And if you can't come, feel free to sow a seed, $25 to help with the expenses or whatever, just sow a seed into the ministry or to even buy a ticket for someone who wants to come and don't have the funds. Whatever you do, it will help. And we are just thankful for each and every one of you. So again, the I Am Fabulous Women's Conference. The theme this year is the power within. Yes, we're going to pull it out and we're going to have an amazing time in God. So thanks everyone for joining me. I am here with your Fab Friday Word of the Day. I try not to be long, but I want to share something. I have been talking to you about this new year and things that we need to do to go to the next level in our new year of being the best that we can be. And one of the things that I'm talking about today is we have to live intentionally. You know, write this down, take a note, I don't know, but there has to be intentional living that goes forth like never before on your part. It doesn't matter what anybody else is doing. What you're believing God for in this season and this hour depends on you. God is looking at the things that you do, the things that you say. He's looking at your obedience. Obedience is better than sacrifice. There are things that God is saying, can I trust you? Can I rely on you? And you have to put in your mind that, you know what? The things that set me back last year, they will not set me back this year. I will go forward in destiny. I will go forward with determination. I will go forward. You have to be intentional about being happy. And one of the things I talked about in my blog was that a lot of times we as people, we think that people will make us happy. We think a new job will make us happy. We think a new environment will make us happy. We think more money will make us happy. But one thing we have to understand is that happiness is within. The Word of God tells us that so as a man thinketh, then so is he. If you think you're unhappy because of X, Y, and Z, then guess what? Chances are you're going to be unhappy. You're going to live a miserable life. But God said no matter what circumstances, situations have come your way, you have to be intentional about being happy. You have to be intentional about living a life with purpose. You have to be intentional about reaching your destiny. I don't care what happened. I don't care what your situations are. You done lost a job, lost a husband, lost whatever. I don't care. God said the what is up to you as to the what. You are the captain of this thing called life. Okay, of your life. And so if you're going to look at somebody else or look at somebody on your job or look at somebody in your family, your friends, because you was happy when y'all was good or you was happy when you was making the money, but now all of a sudden you're not happy because something didn't go right. God said you have to take this time and this season and this hour to dig deep and to look at you and say, no matter what comes my way, I'm going to be intentional about being happy. One of the things I talked about, if you keep focusing on problems, you're going to live in problem land. But if you wake up every day and you're intentional about getting to a solution to a problem that you may have, if you're intentional about going to the next level of being happy, or going to the next level of walking in purpose, or going to the next level of walking in destiny and breakthrough, you have to wake up every day. And you have to be intentional about purpose. You have to be intentional about your destination. You got to be intentional of overcoming fear so that you can live in peace. You have to be intentional about knowing who you are. See, sometimes there are things in life that you got to figure out along the way. Yeah, we know that. We know that there are things that you got to figure out along the way. But as you're figuring things out, you don't have to be depressed. You don't have to be stressed out. You know, I have gone through some of the hardest times of my life. And you know what? I was intentional about being depressed about them. I mean, I intentionally put myself in a depressed situation. Oh, come on, let me tell you something. When life hits you and slaps you in the face, you got a decision to make. You got a decision to make. If you're going to pick your lip up, pick your face up, pick your life up and keep it moving, Susan, or are you going to tuck your tail in and you're going to be depressed? You're going to be frustrated? Or you're going to say, you know what? I choose to live and not die. I choose to walk this thing out by faith. I choose to pull up every ounce of joy on the inside of me, every ounce of peace that God has given me. I choose to manifest that. Instead of manifesting this thing called depression, instead of manifesting this thing called fear, I have to be intentional about where my mind is going to go. I got to be intentional about the things that are going to be released out of my mouth. I got to be intentional about how I'm going to feel, how I'm going to think. You know what I'm saying? Life is going to keep on happening. But if you are intentional about not letting life overcome you and you overcoming life, then I can guarantee you, you are going to reach your purpose. You are going to reach your destiny. You are going to reach breakthrough. See, when I was going through my little ruts, I was intentional about being depressed. Yep, I said it. I was intentional about being depressed because things did not go my way. God was not hearing my prayers. At least I felt like it, and nobody understood. So I was intentional about going to a dark place. Yep, I was intentional about it. I didn't want to think happy thoughts. I didn't want to be happy. I intentionally went to a negative place. I intentionally went to a frustrated place. I intentionally started to allow life to begin to overcome me and put me in a rut. But then one day something happened. One day I decided, I was intentional about this decision, that this was not the way I wanted to live my life. This was not the way I wanted to embrace my destiny. This was not the way I wanted to go on this journey called purpose. This was not it. So I was intentional about coming out of depression. I was intentional about overcoming my fears. How did I do that? I began to read the word and take it at value. Y'all know, some of y'all know I had this one favorite scripture that said, blessed is she who believes that what the Lord has promised her will be accomplished. I was intentional about letting that scripture meditate on the inside of me. I was intentional about believing it through my lack, through my frustration, through my depression. Blessed is she who believes. Blessed means enjoying life. Blessed means enjoying, living, being prosperous. And I, even though at that moment I didn't feel very blessed, I was intentional about changing my mind to a mindset of prosperity, to a mindset of increase, to a mindset of blessings and breakthrough. I was intentional because I realized at that very moment, if I kept being intentional about being depressed about what I didn't have, then I was going to always stay in that place. I was always going to live in that place. But I became intentional when I figured out that enough was enough was enough. I had had enough. I had had enough of the lack. Yes, I was still missing the thing that I was believing God for. No, it had not quite manifested yet. But so as a man thinketh, so is he. For all those months, I was thinking in my mind, I'm depressed. I don't have. I need. I want. God ain't hearing me. God ain't blessing me. You know, I'm struggling. And then my vocabulary began to change. I began to call myself blessed because I believed that God was going to do what he said he was going to do. I began to call myself fruitful and multiplying. I began to open up my mouth and command my day. I began to open up my mouth and command my mindset. I began to open up my mouth and command my body to line up with the word. I began to open up my mouth and command my house to shift into a house of prosperity, to shift into a house of breakthrough. See, I began to command my mouth to bring things into existence that were not in existence. And every single day, I was intentional about changing the way I was thinking. I was intentional about changing the direction that my life was going. I was intentional. Yes, it was a slow process. Yes, I had to get out of that rut. Yes, I was struggling, but I was intentional on being happy. I was intentional on getting out of that rut called depression and frustration and anxiety. Blessed is she who believes. If you're not a she, you can say he. Blessed is she who believes that what the Lord said to her would be accomplished. You know who he was calling blessed at that time? And I'm going to be preaching about this at this conference coming up. Oh, this conference is going to be powerful. So I'm going to give you just one nugget. And this scripture that resonated so powerfully in my mind was the scripture where they were talking about Mary. Mary, who was the one who was about to birth greatness, even though she was a virgin, even though she had never been with a man, even though she had never experienced the things that God had told her she was about to experience. There was a scripture in the Bible that says, blessed is she who believes. Mary had never tapped into the things that she was about to tap into, but her mindset shifted. She began to believe that what the Lord had said to her would be accomplished. When the angel began to speak to her, she had doubts, she had questions because she had never tapped into that realm. And so what happened was when she began to shift her mind into believing that even though she had never accomplished something, that she was about to accomplish it, all because God called her blessed, all because God spoke a word to her spirit man. She was intentional about changing her mindset. What seemed impossible with man, my God, yes, it is. But when you change your mindset and you believe that what God spoke to you will be done, God said, I call you blessed. I call you established. I call you a millionaire. Though you don't see it, you're intentional about seeing it. Being intentional about seeing your prosperity when it comes to money means sometimes you got to take them baby steps. You got to take them steps that people don't know and don't even understand. When you ain't even have making money, but you still taking them steps. When you don't even know what's going on, but all you know is God said, be intentional about what I done told you to do. And even though you don't see an abundance right off, because let me tell you, I didn't see abundance right off, but I was intentional about my obedience unto God. I was intentional about living my life according to what God told me to do, even when I didn't agree with it, even though when I had questions about it, even though when I was more comfortable in Egypt than I was on my way to Canaan, I was intentional about my obedience. I was intentional about my direction. I was intentional about my life because I had the mindset, and y'all can take this and run with it. My mindset is if God said it, that's it. He ain't going to leave me for dead. He's going to take me to a place that's going to bless me more than it stressed me. Even though I'm in that in-between place, Egypt on one side, Canaan on the other, even though I'm in that in-between place, all I know is God said, it's time for you to cross the Red Sea. Now, look at here. When the children of Israel were getting ready to cross the Red Sea, they had enemies on the back side of them. They had the water on the front side of them. And then when God parted the sea, can you imagine how high those waters went up to the sky? And instead of looking back at the enemy and said, you know what, I'm going to go back and let them capture me and let me be a slave again. They were intentional about their obedience to cross the Red Sea. And when they began to cross, can you imagine that you're in that in-between place? You're crossing the Red Sea. You got the Red Sea parted on the left and the right of you. And with one ounce, one spoken word, the waters can come crashing in.
The waters can kill you and everything that's with you. But because you are crossing the Red Sea by faith, and you're intentional about crossing the Red Sea by faith, not by sight, because if you look to the right and the left, the waters and how high they are, it can scare you. It can make you turn your whole life around. It can make you go back to being a slave instead of being on your way to destiny and purpose. If you look to the right and the left of you, you see how high the waters are. But God said, follow me, my daughter. He said, follow me, my son. Be intentional about your obedience in this season. If you just cross the Red Sea like I told you to cross it, you're going to come into a land of abundance. You're going to come into a land of prosperity. Though you're walking on dry land right now, though you don't see any sign of vegetation, you don't see any sign of increase around you. All you know is the waters are above you and they can crash in on you at any time. But because you are intentional about what I told you to do, the waters are not gonna come down on you. All you gotta do is keep walking. All you gotta do is keep believing. All you gotta do is have intentional living about what God told you to do. And as you cross that Red Sea, as you get on over, imagine how they felt when they came across and the waters did not come down on them. Imagine how they felt when they saw that the enemy that was chasing them, they was not chasing them no more. I came to tell you that as you are intentional about your life, that enemy that was chasing you called poverty and lack, you will not see it again. As you are intentional about crossing over into your next area, into your next destiny, into your next way of living, God said the enemy, name it and claim that enemy that's chasing you. But God said your faith, your intentional faith told you to cross over into the Red Sea. Name that enemy that was chasing you in 2017 that actually crossed over into your 2018 and is still looking at you. It's still chasing after you. But God said you are in the midst. You are in that in-between place. I told you with the new moon there was going to be a harvest. All I need you to do is cross that Red Sea. For those of y'all that missed it, I prophesied that there was a new moon that was going to come. And it was going to, I prophesied this on Watch Night Service, that there was a new moon that was going to come and it was going to symbolize harvest for God's children. Right after I prophesied that, a week later they made an announcement that there was going to be a quote new moon, a blue moon, some type of eclipse that was going to happen on January 31st. And shortly after the word was prophesied, the manifestation was hitting. It was hitting in the airways. It was hitting in the sky. It was hitting. And God said, just as surely as that enemy crossed over with you in the new year, and I declared and I decreed that the new moon was going to represent the abundance, just as surely as you're in that in-between place, God said, don't you know, my son and my daughter, that I'm going to bless you, but you got to be intentional about your obedience. Even when it don't feel good, when it don't look good, when it don't sound good, you got to be intentional about your obedience to what God told you to do, so that the waters to your right and your left, they ain't gonna stop you. They are not going to knock you. They ain't gonna block you. And that thing that was chasing you, it can't cross over with you. You got to be intentional. You got to be intentional about what God is telling you to do. Obedience is better than sacrifice. I'm telling y'all, if y'all hear me, you receive that word that I prophesied on Watch Night. I don't know about y'all, but I've already started to see the manifestation of that word. Every time my husband said, I said, oh, that new moon, God prophesied it. Every time he says something and happened, that new moon, God prophesied it. If you missed it, go to my YouTube page. It was a prophetic word. You let it minister to your spirit. You let it minister to your heart. And if you do like I do, you take it and run with it, because let me tell you something. I don't just prophesy to you, I prophesy to me too. And when God speaks something through me to give to the masses, I receive it first. So when my husband said, look, honey, this just happened, I said, oh, God spoke it, new moon, that's it, that harvest, that's a manifestation of harvest, that's a manifestation of breakthrough, that's a manifestation, new moon. I receive it, I take it and run with it, and I'm intentional about seeing manifestation. If God said it, that's it. Y'all gotta have that mindset in this year. See, some of us frustrated because that same devil that was chasing us in 2017 2017, it actually crossed over into 2018. And you ain't quite received that you were believing God for yet. But I'm here to tell you, that enemy that came in with you, you're not going to see it no more. At some time through this year, at some point through this year, you're going to begin to see breakthrough after breakthrough after breakthrough. Only if you're intentional about seeing the manifestation of God's word. Only if you're intentional about the obedience that God put in your heart. Only if you're intentional are you going to see and see the fruit of the harvest of the new moon that God spoke to us on that watch night service. It is at hand. Greatness is at hand. Breakthrough is at hand. But you got to be intentional in your faith. You got to be intentional in your mindset. You got to know that you know that you know that if God said it, that's it. I'm living an intentional life in 2018 and no devil in hell, no witch, no warlock, no sorcerer, no psychic, no nothing is going to stop what God is doing. It's all about intentional living. Intentional living produces intentional purpose. Intentional purpose produces intentional destiny. Intentional destiny is just leading you straight to breakthrough after breakthrough after breakthrough. It's all about being intentional. So I pray that this spoke something volumes to somebody's spirit man today. I pray that it did, and that you take this word and you run with it, because God is about to manifest. I don't care what it looks like right now. I told you I'm slowly seeing manifestations of the word of the harvest, the new moon harvest. I'm slowly seeing manifestation. I don't care what it looks like right now. You keep declaring your new moon harvest. God said it. That's it. If you his child, then you were supposed to get that word and run with it too. So go back to my YouTube page, Prophetess Trish Morissette, and listen to that word and let it bless your soul. Listen to this word again and again today, as often and as much as you need to. Let it bless your soul. Let it encourage your faith, because we got work to do. We got intentional living to pursue every single day. Live your life with intention. Don't forget to share this word with somebody. Personally, inbox it, share it on your page, share it in groups, share it, because somebody needs to hear it. All right, you guys, I hope you have an amazing weekend. Thank you all for tuning in, and I'm going to be looking for some testimonies soon and very soon. In Jesus' name, amen. Love you all.